Joining us is Mr. V. Kalyanarama, CMD, Concor India. Thank you for talking to Bloomberg Quint. So what is the impact you're seeing of GST on the sector?
See, GST, as of now, the export-import trade by containers is going on as usual, but in domestic side, yes, there is some slowdown. But I feel people are still, and the trade industry, they're trying to understand how GST is impacting them. Not only on the logistics side, but on the supply side and the consumption side also, people are still understanding the effects of GST. It will take some time for us to understand the GST effects. So maybe, and definitely we'll be able to understand very fast.
What are the challenges that you're facing during this transition period?
The challenge is a little slowdown, yes. So other than that, there's not much challenge. And I don't think that will really affect the business. I'm hopeful, I'm optimist. So I'm expecting the people to understand the business, the GST effects very fast, and then they come back. So they have to do some sort of business re-engineering. See, here I'll tell you, the billing of a logistic service and when the product is moving from the manufacturer to the customer. Earlier, it may be in a different mode. Now, how it is to be billed, who has to pay the logistics cost, who has to pay the transportation cost, on whom it is to be billed, all these things are going to matter how the GST credit will pass on. And without getting effect of that GST onto anyone in the entire supply chain link. So these things require little more understanding. Even though people, we are well prepared, from Concor side, we are well prepared. We implemented GST on the July 1st and we started issuing GST compliant invoices right from the stroke of the midnight. When Honorable Prime Minister launched the GST, we also started the issuing GST invoice. But all the other stakeholders in the supply chain link also have to come to the same level of understanding, and they should do their business re-engineering. Maybe somewhere some missing links are there. Once they get connected, the things will get smoothened out.
What is the update on the dedicated freight corridor which Railways Ministry is planning, and when can we expect it to be completed?
See, this is not concerned with me, so I go with the guidances given by the Dedicated Freight Corporation. I think 2019 is the most probable date that the train should start running on one of the legs. The expected is Mundra Pipava Port to Rewari. So that definitely will help the container logistics industry, movement of containers by double stacks. It will definitely help the rail-based, and also, as I mentioned in the conference, the multimodal operations.
Which are the new projects coming up?
I told, as I mentioned, if you are recorded in the conference, we are present at 72 locations today in India. And this financial year, we will be definitely doing 7 projects. So we will be there at 79 by the end of this FY. And our plan, in 3 years' time, by 2020, to be present at 100 locations, where 90% of it will be owned by us. And 10 maybe on some sort of agreements.
So what is the volume growth outlook that you're looking at?
See, for this financial year, we already gave our guidance in our first conference call itself that we will be looking at 10 to 12% growth in both volumes and in our finances.
Last question, how are you looking at improving the margin output ahead?
We are following a lot of initiatives. Many times I mentioned this, but for the sake of once more explaining, the 2-3 things what we are doing is, one is double stack operations. The section available today is between Rewari and Mundra Pipava. We are using it extensively. We really pushed it up, and our target this year is to do 50% more double stack operations than last year. So we are working on it with the existing infrastructure. Second is timely clearances from ports, so that customers will be more satisfied, customers will be there, and more business will be able to get onto rail and multimodal operations. And third thing is ITES based services in all my terminals. So there are many things in ITES, maybe too long to explain now, but IT enabled service, with the help of IT enabled services, we want to give more customer satisfaction. That automatically reduces the cost for us and also for the customers, and it helps in improving the margins. These are the major three, and there are many other things we are working on to improve our margins. So we are looking at the growth of 10-12% this year.
All right, thank you for talking. Right. To me.